Many times we don't realize who is in our midst until we lose them. Then we begin to say, oh, I didn't know. Too late. My brothers and sisters, mawtul alimi falmatun la tusaddu. The death of a true scholar of Islam is a gap that's created that won't be filled exactly as it was. And why we say this is because as much as there are many scholars in our midst, we need to know. The Prophet ﷺ tells us one of the signs of the hour is that knowledge will be snatched away. Because people won't appreciate the knowledge. They won't want to know. At the time of the Prophet ﷺ, they had a habit. No matter what was told to them, they said, سَمِعْنَا وَأَطَعْنَا. Immediately they said, we have heard, we have obeyed. Imagine if the Prophet ﷺ came to us now and told us, alcohol is prohibited, pornography is prohibited, gambling is prohibited, riba is prohibited. Many from amongst us who fulfill salah 5 times a day or more would have an issue with him and disagree. Na'udhu billah. We would say, hey, but you know, it's like this and it's like that, and there's something this way and that way. That is why we are not sahaba. That is why we are not companions. The companions were those whom, when they had a little bit of alcohol coming into their mouths, they would spit it out, and they have spat it out. As soon as a messenger came to them, telling them that the Prophet ﷺ said this, without initial verification, what did they lose? By spitting it out. Today, when people tell you, be careful, this is not certified halal, we'll say, it's okay. As it is, they have disputes amongst them. I am just going to chow. That's the word.